In this video, we're going to take a look at three brand new effects inside of Boris Effects Continuum 2023.5. The effects in question are BCC plus light flicker, orbs, as well as smoke and fog. You should know that you can apply these stylistically to clips, as well as text or alpha-based sources. Let's take a look at this inside of Premiere Pro. I have a sequence open, and I've already done a search in my effects panel for light flicker. Let's apply that to the first clip here in my timeline. You may have seen a subtle shift in the colors here within the program monitor, but I'll just move to the beginning and then play back so you can see the sort of pulsating light flicker that's taking place. To really get a sense for this effect, I'm gonna press Shift 5 and click on the effects editor badge at the top, and is in fact at the top of every single BCC Plus effect. Here on the left-hand side, we can get a sense for a variety of presets that we can use. I'll select fast blinking. And while this isn't quite playing in real time, we can get a sense for the movement of the flicker. I'll head back up here to the default light flicker, and let's start to play around with the parameters on the right-hand side of the interface. And before we do that, we're going to activate one property. Let's scroll down closer to the bottom of the effect. What I'd like you to do is turn on curve view, and we're going to just render it over the effect in this case. What we're seeing right now is when the flicker occurs. So right now the flicker brightens when we see the top part of the graph, and will darken when we see the bottom. This is because if you scroll up in the parameters, by default, the flicker style is set to alternate between bright and dark. Right now, the graph, if I scroll down, the time view is currently set to full effect. So we're seeing this over the entire duration of the clip, and you can now see where those flickers hit at their high points and their low points. Let's stop playback, scroll back up to the top of the effect, and first off, let's change the speed to maximum, which is 100, to take a look at how our graph now changes. Not to mention, let's change the flicker type from its default of smooth to spiky. We have a much more aggressive flicker, which we can see visually, not to mention identified by the graph. I'm going to stop playback. We can change the colors involved in the flicker, and we can also change the flicker style. In some cases, you might just want to have the flicker brighten the source shot. If I change this to brighten only, now the entire bottom portion of that graph disappears, and we're only flickering to a brighter color. I'll stop playback, change the flicker style back to alternate bright and dark, and introduce one of my other favorite parameters, which is noise. If you start to drag noise, it essentially is going to randomize your entire spiky graph in this instance, creating, in some cases, a more realistic flicker, as we can see here, because it's not a constant source. Playing around with noise smoothing can have this not be as aggressive, and you also have the ability to add some flicker randomness, as well as intensity randomness. In addition to your flicker, let's turn off render over effect to off. We have a prism control inside of flicker, which can also be activated just to have a little bit of separation in the red, green, and blue channels of our clip. I'm going to stop playback and just press apply and bring your attention to one other flicker example inside of my Premiere Pro timeline. In this case, we have a much more pulsating flicker there. We can see here the change in color, almost acting like an alarm going off in a building. I'm just going to stop playback, and with my clip selected, go inside the effects editor, and let's go to the parameters of this effect, noticing that the flicker style is set to brighten only, and let's check how that flicker appears over the effect. A much smoother flicker, having less of an impact over time, the speed being set to an amount of 10. That, along with a large red amount and lower green and blue amounts, gives the flicker a red color. So definitely something to check out in more detail. Let's now move on to BCC Plus Orbs. Okay, I'm here inside of another sequence, and I've already done a search for BCC Plus Orbs in the effects panel. I'm just going to apply that from the BCC Plus Film Style category onto the clip. Now, by default, if I just play this back, we can see that these orbs have a speed attached to them, as well as a certain amount appears on screen and they begin to then fade off based on something called an illumination radius. If I increase that radius, you'll see that the vignetting at the edge of the screen and feathering becomes a lot less. And we can now increase the count of the orbs, seeing them further across our screen. Now, we do have an alternative to this. One is we could actually have a very small illumination radius for our orbs and then decide on a light source. So I'll put that over the subject and then invert the illumination. Now you can see that the orbs are around the subject, and then we can play with the illumination radius and its position until we get it right. If we move further down, we can play with the scale of the orbs. In this case, I'll make a lot of these smaller, but then randomize the scale amount so that some are large and some are a lot smaller here in this shot. Let's also bring down the color randomness. I'll set that to a very low value of 10 in this case. We'll see that the base color is white, and then there's only small variations amongst the orbs. Let's change the color in this case to a cyan. And notice what a low color randomness does. We'll just keep the speed at a default of 25 for now, but notice how the orbs move very independently away from each other. And that is because of the coherence value being set fairly low. If we set this to a value of 100, they're going to move more in unison together, kind of in a straight line, and then slightly reverse direction, go along a different path. We could easily change that up. I'll bring down the coherence to a higher value of 75 in this case, and then just bring the speed down to a very low value of 2. Let's see what we have here with our orbs. Last but not least, there's a subtle flicker that's happening with our orbs, and we can increase that flicker and flicker speed to be a lot more aggressive, depending on the type of look that we're going for. Orbs will work great on text-based sources. In this case, I'll just apply orbs to the text source that I have in a nest here within Premiere Pro, open up the effects editor, where we can see a few presets and how they might be useful in our graphic design. Let's settle on this purple maze preset, and I'll come just over here to the parameters and change the color to an orange. Apply, and let's see that back in our host. Last but not least, we have Smoke and Fog. So I'm here inside of a new sequence, and I'll just clear my search and type in the word smoke, and we'll find that in the film style category. I'll apply it to the text-based clip. And the reason I'm doing this towards anything with an alpha channel is that we can actually see smoke a little bit clearer this way when we begin to work with it. If we go into the smoke section, one thing that we can do is change the default sprite that we're working with. Right now it's set to fuzzy, but there are many different types of smoke bases that you can explore, which will give you different stylistic looks. I'll go with storm. Very similar to orbs, we've got a speed as well as a coherence control and the overall scale of the smoke. Now, by default, this happens to be mixed with a bunch of fog parameters that gives the smoke an overall haze. I'm going to just increase the speed of this smoke here to a value of 5. Increase the contrast and also set the coherence to a higher value so we can take a look at this stormy-based smoke. And keep in mind, by playing with some of these parameters like density and scale, we can get very different looks depending on what we're going for. I'm just going to move to the next example in my timeline to show you that smoke has been added. I'll just turn this off and on. And if we head inside the effects editor, a preset called Jazz Club was applied, and some subtle variations were made to the smoke's default speed and contrast. In fact, this was set to be a lot slower to give the final result that's showing in my timeline. Of course, any preset can be altered in terms of its properties. Looking at the final example, we have something that doesn't look like even smoke at all, but happens to add a glitter-based source on top of our footage here. If I head inside of the effects editor, let's take a look at the parameters here on the side and change the blend mode temporarily to none, where you can see that based on the smoke-based source being dots, we have these really tiny dots that look like glitter in this instance and mixing in with the color orange. Setting that now to a blend mode of add in this shot and a relatively high coherence allows us to integrate this type of glitter within the shot. One thing to keep in mind is that these three new effects are combined into one called BCC plus atmospheric glow, which contains additional sections that you can use creatively and stylistically. For more tips and tricks just like this, don't forget to subscribe to the Boris Effects channel. Please comment and like and let us know what you'd like to see in an upcoming video.